our differences is a work of art. The world is brighter, yeah, brighter. What we all really need right now is an upbeat song to sing, an upbeat song to sing. It feels good when we're together. It feels good when we belong. It feels right when we're united. No divides, living life as one. Life is better together. What we all really need right now is an upbeat song to sing, an upbeat song to sing. It feels
good. Afternoon, everybody, and welcome to Messy Church at Home. Greetings from our home to yours, and thank you for joining us this afternoon. Our last Messy Church at Home, we celebrated birthdays, and if you've got a birthday either in June or July, then stand up where you are, because we would like to wish you a happy birthday.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, happy birthday. Happy birthday to you.
Once again, to those who have had a birthday in June and July, a very happy birthday from us all. We now come to our craft activity, and like we did last time, we're going to do it live. So in front of you, you will need a gingerbread man and some icing pens. And we're going to show you now a video on what to do. And if you haven't got those now, then you can watch this again and join it later on.
You got a friend in me. You got a friend in me. When the road looks rough ahead and you're miles and miles from your nice warm bed, you just remember what your old pal said. Boy, you got a friend in me. Yeah, you got a friend in me. You got a friend in me. You got a friend in me. If you got troubles, I got them too. There isn't anything I wouldn't do for you. We stick together and see it through. 'Cause you got a friend in me. Yeah, you got a friend in me. Some of the folks might be a little bit smarter than I am, bigger and stronger too, maybe, but none of them would ever love you the way I do. It's me and you, boy, and as the years go by, our friendship will never die. You will see it's our destiny. You got a friend in me. You got a friend in me. Yeah, you got a friend in me.
We hope that you enjoy doing those crafts. And if you've done a gingerbread man, then why not send a picture and show us what you have done, either on our Facebook page or on the YouTube channel. Share what you have made. I'm going to show you some signs, and I wonder how you would feel if this sign was aimed at you. The first sign: No children allowed on this site. Second sign. Warning. Children left unattended will be sold to the circus. These are not welcoming signs, are they? And I wonder how you would feel if you saw these signs. Would you feel welcomed? Would you feel accepted? Well, Rebecca's now going to share a story with us about when Jesus welcomes the children.
Hi, Rev Matt. Hi, everyone. It's good to join you at Messy Church again. I've come to tell you a story. It's about Jesus and the children. The children loved to spend time with Jesus. But the disciples didn't understand. They said, "Stop, do not bother Jesus. He is too busy." Jesus told the disciples, "Let the children come to me. Do not keep them away. You must be like these little children if you want to enter the kingdom of heaven." Then Jesus blessed the children. I hope you like that story. I'll see you again soon. Bye.
Thank you, Reverend Rebecca. The story that we've just heard, people were bringing children to Jesus, but Jesus' friends stopped them. And Jesus noticed this and he says to his friends, "Don't stop the children from coming to me. That if you are to enter my God's room, then you must be like this child." It's a story that is the opposite to those signs. It says that it doesn't matter if you are a couple of months or years, you are truly welcome. It's a story that tells us it doesn't matter if you are 1, 5, 10, 13, 33, 40, 60, 80, 90 or 100. We are all children of God. And that God looks at us and he loves us because we are his children. And that you are truly welcome. And maybe you're watching this video and you want to know more about the love of Jesus. Maybe you are a child watching this. Then let me encourage you to know more about the love of Jesus. And that could be at Messy Church at home or going to a church physically when we reopen. That you are truly welcome and that we don't want to stop you because you I've got a story to share. And just because adults have maybe been on this world a lot longer, it doesn't mean that you can't teach us anything. Actually, we can learn a lot from you. And as Jesus said, "Let the children come to me." There's a reason why we've looked at this story is because today is a very special day. And I'm going to allow Stephen and Myrtle to share that with you. So let's cross over to Stephen and Myrtle's.
Thank you, Matt, and welcome again to Stephen and I's Open House. We come back. Being at home is a joy, isn't it? And one of the sadnesses of lockdown is we've had to stay in our homes and not travel around. And I wonder how many of you have travelled around in the past and been to Waterloo Station. Because it was at Waterloo Station nearly 150 years ago that a Methodist minister called Thomas Stevenson was walking and found children who were living under the arches of Waterloo Station, homeless, looking after themselves. And he just couldn't leave it like that. He had to do something. And so Thomas Stevenson set up an organisation. He set up a home for young children who were homeless, who were in need. It was called the National Children's Home way back then. And it was Fred and George, two young boys, who were the first ones who went. And since then, that organisation has sought to care and look after children in whatever way has been needed over the years. The name has changed. It's no longer National Children's Home. At one stage, it became NCH. And now it's called Action for Children, so that people can know that we seek to work for children and with children. Thomas Stevenson was a Methodist minister, so it's been very much at the heart of the Methodist Church to remember that work. And myself, when I started in ministry, one of the first things I did for a year was to work with the National Children's Home in Ladywood in Birmingham. And then when I moved to Jamaica, I spent my first 3 months working for the NCH in Jamaica. So it's close to my heart that we as a church seek to look after all children, whatever their situation. And so this Sunday is a special Sunday where we remember that work. Special Sunday where we want to think of all of those children who are in need. And so we invite you to learn about them and to know more about that work. But we might not have money to give, but what we can do is we can pray for them. And I'm going to invite Stephen to come and pray.
Thank you, Myrtle. Sometimes when we are in somebody else's home, or as you are now looking at our house, you think, I wonder what's behind them. So let me show you what's behind me. Here is what's one of the things behind me. It's a carving that we bought a long time ago when we went to Israel. And it's a carving of Joseph and Mary and the baby Jesus. And it's important for us to remember that Jesus was a child. And the theme of the Action for Children Special Sunday today is Children Matter. So when I say, thank you, Jesus, will you, in our prayers, shout out, thank you, Jesus. Let's pray together. Thank you, Jesus, that every child matters. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you for every child all over the world this day. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you especially for those children who are our friends. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you for every family, whatever the size, whatever the makeup of that family, for mums, for dads, for grandparents, brothers and sisters, aunts and uncles. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
And today we want to say thank you for the work of Action for Children, who care for so many children who do not have an easy life. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
And so we thank you that I matter, everyone matters, and today every child matters to you. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Amen.
Amen.
And now we're going to visit another mother and child, not Mary and Jesus, but Ruth and Joel. Over to you.
Thank you, Myrtle and Stephen. Right, it's time to get on your feet. We're going to sing a song. Dance, do whatever you feel like, and it's got a bit of go to it, and it's called God Loves You and I Love You, and that's the way it should be. over to Matt.
Thank you, Ruth and Joel. Thank you everyone for joining us at Messy Church at Home this afternoon, and we hope that you have all enjoyed yourselves. And if you have, then why not like this video on our Facebook page and YouTube channel, and to share it with all your family and friends. And don't forget to share the pictures of what you've been making this afternoon. Today's message is that we are all loved by God, and that we are all welcomed because we are God's children, and it doesn't matter how old we are, from 0 to 100+, we are truly welcomed by God. And if you'd like to know more about what we do, then like our Facebook page, and all our activities and services can be found on there with a link to our website. We will let you know when our next Messy Church at Home is going to be on our Facebook page and Twitter. And now we're going to share the messy grace, and the words will appear behind me. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all, now and forever. Amen.
When we see our differences as a work of art, the world is brighter, yeah, brighter. What we all really need right now is an upbeat song to sing, an upbeat song to sing. It feels good.